All right, so good morning. Today I'm going to talk of the allegiances with Britain and the EU. And yeah, with their little pound action and what we're going to do about it. I know a few videos back I said pompous Britain, but in reality we can't lose them either. So what we need to do is we have to have some, it's going to have to be a stronghold or a click change, something that every little business in Britain can compete, can trade. I know a lot of them don't want to, but they have to have an easy ability to just change into euros, have their pounds switched into euros without fees, being able to ship outside of Britain without any fees, nothing extra. So it's like, okay, from, we'll say, what is it called, White, they have that Dover or whatever, Whitehead or some little town out there. You know, so they ship from there and they normally go to Bristol. Or is that the town, name of the town? I'm terrible with the towns. They go to Bristol, yeah. Okay, so they go to Bristol, and then it's like, well, yeah, normally that costs a certain amount of money. So it has to be the same amount, you know, to ship off to Budapest. The same amount to ship off to Milan. So we have to have this, you know, so it's not this estranged island of extra problems, paperwork, red tape, extraordinary fees with the banking system to have commerce. Free commerce with the EU. You know, as soon as you start putting on all of these change fees, you end up with a terrible drama of like, oh no, I'm not, you know, it's too terrible. You know, and they're already afraid, you know, they're already afraid as small businessmen that they're going to even lose their shipment. You know, they're afraid they're going to lose whatever was sent. You know, they have, you know, then we have to worry about, well, so some insurance company will step in there and try to overhike them with insurance fees. Now, we can't have that either. We have to have it be the same as, you know, if you're going from shipping your business products from France to Germany, if you're shipping your products from Britain to Germany, it has to be the same price. So we really need to accommodate the business of Britain. If we do not accommodate the business of Britain, then you are just a shrunken head syndrome. You are just there like the Papua New Guineas, you know. And that doesn't affect anybody in a great way. You know, we can't really lose you. We're big out here. All of these other countries, all these other pays are huge, but we don't want to lose you, because if we lose you, then we have a market turmoil upset, and we have like loans falling out. Oh, we had a loan there because we're Saudis, and then this becomes a problem. So no, we don't want to lose Britain. We want you to play and not being such a stupidity. We want you to have an even playing field with other businesses in the EU. Very simple. So here, the gamut here, the gamut of the calamity, it's all going to finger point immediately to the banks. The banking system has just run havoc on prices and fees on the small business. The banking system. So your cutesies list, we love Barclays, and yes, we love this, and yes, we love the HSBC, or we love all this hype. These banks have been just just taking advantage. We can't have that any longer. Now, that is a regulation that has to happen within Britain. That is something that is just thinking, sorry, you guys have to curtail your actions. This is not a money-making scheme any longer against the businesses of Britain. You squash them, you know, just for the hold of maybe three or four major monopoly businesses, you are still going to end up in a devastating economic collapse. You cannot do that. You cannot just, hey, the pride city of we have, you know, maybe five or ten greats and that's all we need. No. You've got to support the businesses, the small businesses in the middle, the medium-sized businesses. You have got to support them and allow them to have this good, gracious interchange amongst the EU at least. My gosh. So easy requisitioning into the euro so they can have accounts, bank accounts, that are dual action. And that's very possible without any interchange fees. Okay? So it's stated in euro and stated in pounds. So essentially, so when they're looking at their bank balance at the end of the day, it says that they have 100,000 in euro, or they have the, yeah, switch it into the pounds. They have, 75,000 in pounds or whatever, or 50,000 in pounds, whatever the rate is. So they'll just have that dual equality right there on the bank statements. Okay, so this is, I'm sorry, you guys need a spanking? All of you British regulations there, what are you doing? What are you doing? Stop it. So who's the queen?